Dear friends, when compared to people who made tribute to Kamlesan Annan, my association with Kamlesan Annan is very, very limited only. I came to know Kamlesan Annan through his deep messages through Satya Vasana. Then later on, I attended FMEP summer camps, and then through Annan's deep messages in missionary work and its impact on the society, I came to regard Christianity as a very, very good religion. Because earlier, because of my Hindu background, I was not knowing much about Christianity. Because of my parents, I was thinking that it's a foreign organization and it is having foreign values. Then, Annan's sensitiveness to include everybody, making everybody comfortable in a meeting, was very, very well known. In a particular meeting, before starting message in Danishpet, he asked if anybody does not know Tamil. When only one lady raised her hand, he asked Mrs. Kripakaran Annan to go and sit beside that lady and translate his Tamil message to her language. This really surprised me, and I understood his sensitiveness to and inclusiveness to all. Then later on, Annan was responsible for making FMPP a holistic ministry. This is one incident Israel Devadas Annan, a senior missionary, told me. Once there was a prayer meeting in Kukna area in Gujarat. After the meeting was over, Kamlesan Annan came out and saw many children of various ages, naked and semi-naked, and then running here and there playing. When Annan asked why these people do not go to school, he was told that these people have no schools nearby, and when he came to know that, he immediately made steps to open children's home with the help of World Vision, and that is the beginning of FMPP being an evangelistic organization to become a holistic missionary organization. Another occasion was in an executive meeting, the same Israel Devadas Annan told the problem in his ministry is lot of backsliding because believers stayed there in the mission field for 6 months only. 6 months they went to nearby big cities to earn their livelihood. When I asked what is the reason, low agriculture productivity. Immediately Annan asked, Edward Raja, being an agriculture scientist, why don't you help these people? Then with the help of EFICOR, we introduced many rice varieties, tour dal varieties, and then vegetable varieties from our institute, and then their livelihood was improved, and their migration was stopped. Many of us were knowing that the recent lockdown, corona related lockdown, many migrants were really migrants because of the failed agriculture. So Kamlesan Annan started giving steps to stop migration around 20 years back. So that is his commitment to the missions. Another thing is his humility, some Christian values he taught us. For a Sandhya meeting, Annan came to deliver the message. On the way, he saw some torn, damaged Hawaii chappals. But though many of us were passing through that, none of us cared to remove it. So it was looking very ugly. So Annan took that chappal, torn chappal, and then put it in a very safe place which is not looking ugly. So that showed Annan's concern and then humility. One more occasion, my wife and cousin sisters, after hearing a deep message, they took some decisions and wanted Annan's prayer. So when he was going back to his house after the message, my wife and his cousin sister asked him to pray for their decisions to be implemented. He prayed and finally he asked, Enakkaagum jeevanningalamma, will you also pray for me? Like that he asked. They were very much touched by Annan's humility. And there are many occasions that Annan has impacted the life of FMPP's supporters as well as prayer group leaders. I thank God for his life. Thank you.